Io, moon of Jupiter. It is the most active object in our solar system, with a volcano erupting every few minutes and spewing a large amount of matter into space. Just in this picture, you can see a volcano erupting. It was taken live from a Galileo spacecraft. It is just slightly bigger than our own moon, with a diameter of 3,600 kilometers. It has the least amount of water out of any object in our solar system. We can see that it is a young moon because there are barely any craters on its surface. Now, it is called a land of ice and fire for a reason. While standing near a volcano, it would get 1600 Celsius, an instant death, and that's just standing near it. While just standing on a normal spot, not being near a volcano, it would be minus 130 Celsius. You would probably be then covered in a sulfur dioxide snow, because the surface is mostly made of sulfur. A variation of temperature on Io is insane, a true fire and ice world. Because Jupiter is so close, you would die from radiation poisoning in a few hours. Future humans would have to create suits to protect us from these almost unprotectable conditions, but you would feel very light on Io, about 5.5 times lighter because its gravity is 5.5 times weaker than ours, which really is not a good thing for our bones at all. That's also the problem with all low gravity planets and space itself. We humans are always limited to Earth. Even sending an unmanned rover on Io would be hard, or maybe not even possible. Atmosphere on Io is extremely thin, with a variation of color. It would be barely possible to see it with a human eye, but it does exist, and it contains mostly sulfur dioxide and other elements that are not good at all for breathing in, even deadly, but it does contain just a tiny bit of oxygen. Pressure also just barely exists, which is not good for human bones as well. Looking at a horizon, we would see very tall sulfur mountains going up to 6,000 meters on average, and it has a lot of peaks going taller than Mount Everest, the tallest mountain on Earth, with the tallest mountain on Io being Buzul Montes, which is 17,500 meters high, double the height of Mount Everest. Altogether, it has over 100 mountains, so it's definitely not a flat place. Looking up, we would see no other than Jupiter. It would take up a very large portion because they are only 400,000 kilometers apart. Also, other moons of Jupiter would be visible at times. So, sending a human crew to Io is basically a suicide mission. But all in all, it is worth investing time into learning about this fascinating moon, but we should learn about it from a distance. If in future we would be able to create a rover that would be immune to such hostile environment, it would be a good idea to send it to Io.